This coming Sunday, it's going to be a blessed time of worship. It's going to be a blessed time of, he's going to bring the word. He's a blessing. We love Ryan Weller. So if you can make it, if you're new here or whatever, Sunday's going to be a blessing as well. So I just, let's pray. Let's just pray right now. I ask that you guys would just pray that God would just give you a thirsty heart. I ask that you pray for one another, pray for yourselves, pray that God would give you a word tonight. Because God is faithful to speak. He's faithful. He wants to communicate to his children, and we don't want to put him in a box. I'm trusting that God will give each and every single one of you a word tonight that you can take home, that will stick, that will change you. He's faithful to speak. So I just ask that you guys would just pray for yourselves, pray for all of us here. I know this. God can use a donkey to preach to you if you're hungry. If the whole congregation is hungry, God will use a donkey to speak to you. It's not about me. I'm just your brother. The message that's going to come tonight, is, I know it's from the Lord. I believe God has given me a word for every single one of us. So let's just pray, God. Just call on the Lord. Don't be shy here. Father, we just come before you, God. Lord, I pray, God, that you would speak to us, God. Jesus, I pray that you would give us a hungry heart to hear from you, God. Lord, I pray, God, that you would just give us thirsty hearts, God. I pray, God, that you would feed your children tonight, God. I pray, God, that you would just descend, God, upon us, Lord. I pray for your mercy, God. I pray, God, for mercy, Jesus, for every single one of us tonight, God, that you would have mercy to speak to us, God. I pray, God, get me out of the way. Lord, I have nothing apart from you. I'm the weakest one here, God. I know that to be true, God. I pray for your mercy. I pray that you would anoint me. I pray that you would supply what I lack, God. I pray, God, that you would just quicken my mind and quicken my heart to preach this word with freedom tonight, Lord. God, and I pray, God, that you would come against right now every demonic hindrance, God, any spirit of weariness, lethargy, God, that would just make us stupid from hearing your word. God, I pray against that, God. God, I pray for holy grippings. God, I pray you grip their minds and grip their hearts, God. Grip my mind and grip my heart, God. Grip us, God. Would you speak to us tonight, Lord? We have nothing apart from you, God. But we know this, God, that even when we're faithless, you remain faithful, for you cannot deny yourself. We know we're trusting in your faithfulness, God. We're trusting in your mercy. We're trusting that you're going to speak to us, God. Right now, Lord, I ask, God, for your anointing, God. I pray, Holy Spirit, put a fire in me. Light me up, God, for your name's sake, God. May I disappear, God. You preach, Jesus. You preach, God. You preach, Lord. We thank you, God, for what you're going to do, God. I pray for strongholds to be broken tonight. Tonight, Lord God. Tonight, he who the Son sets free is free indeed. Tonight, Lord, you said if you being evil, now to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give the Holy Spirit to those who ask? All of us here tonight, Lord, we ask for your Spirit to come tonight, Lord. Please, God. We thank you, God. We thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. We're going to be in Matthew chapter 14, starting in verses 22. Give me a Matthew chapter 14, verses 22. And man, I was just praying, like, God, I don't know what to preach on, Lord. What do you want to speak to your children? So I was wrestling over several different topics, and I was just like, Lord, I don't know. And God just laid this right on my lap. And I know that God wants to do a work tonight. I know this, where we're going to be at, has to do with the battle between fear and anxiety. Fear and anxiety. But there's so much more to it. But man, I know that God, you know what I mean? Like, God wants to speak to us. And so many times, the Lord has dropped Holy Spirit bombshells from this pulpit for those who struggle with fear and anxiety and different things. And we can get convicted. We can come up here. We can cry. We can weep. We can ask God for forgiveness. But how come there's, like, very little change? How come, like, we can hear the word of the Lord, we can receive it, get convicted, cut to the heart, if you will, come up here, you know, and just weep and cry? I'm talking about many of us. You know, we know that God speaks to us. He can rock our core to the beam and be cut to the heart. And we can come up here and, you know, and cry and weep and confess and all that. But how come there's no change? How come, like, we're still stuck in bondage? You know, so many of us here, why are we still stuck in bondage to the same thing? Because the truth is this, the Holy Spirit can ignite anybody. You know, and I've been repped to the core by Pastor Scott and Matt and others here that preach, Pastor Josh and Jay. But man, I've been rocked to the core. But we can get rocked to the core and come and confess and all these different things and still be stuck in gossip, still be stuck in fear, still be stuck in anxiety, still be bound with lust, still be chasing that American dollar. But what is it, man? It's this. We hear the word of the Lord. You know, the Bible says to confess our sins, right? No, to confess and forsake. So we need to, you know, if the Lord speaks tonight, don't just come up here and cry and weep and confess. Go home and deal with that thing. Wrestle with it until it's done. Man, we got to obey the word. You know, we got to receive from the Lord. We got to hear and obey the word of God. And if we actually obey the word of God, man, God will do those breakthroughs in our hearts, man. God wants to do that. He wants to set us free. He doesn't want us to be walking around with, like, spiritual bricks, you know, that we're dragging around. He wants us to run, man. That's his will. But how can we run? How is God going to bless us, right? How is God going to pour out the Spirit of God upon us? How can we walk in the power of God and that freedom if we're not obeying the Word of God? We can hear the Word of God over and over and over again, be convicted, but still not obey. You know what I'm saying? There's a difference, man. It's not just come in here and get the prayer. It's, man, go home and fight until that thing is dealt with, man. And I'm preaching to me too, by the way. All right, so let's start. We're going to be in Matthew chapter 14, starting in verse 22. In this portion of scripture, Jesus just sent the 5,000 away. He just fed the 5,000. He just sent them away. We're going to pick it up right now. Matthew chapter 14, verses 22. Come, Lord Jesus. Immediately, Jesus made his disciples get into the boat and go before him to the other side, while he sent the multitudes away. And when he had sent the multitudes away, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When evening came, he was alone. But the boat was now in the middle of the sea, tossed by the winds and the waves, for the wind was contrary. So Jesus just sent the multitudes away. How come? I mean, we hear different theologians talk about it. But, you know, in that portion of scripture, they talked about how Jesus, you know, Jesus was saying how they wanted to take him by force and make him king. Therefore, he sent them to the other side. And I don't feel that at all, man, when you start seeking the Lord in that. The truth is, he just wanted a break. He just wanted a break, man, to go and be alone with his Father. He sent away his disciples, and he sent away the people. He just wanted a break to go and be alone with his Father because, you know what? People can drive you crazy. Things can drive you crazy. He just wanted a break to be alone with his Father. But also, it's more than that. He knew the world's greatest need is for him to be alone with his Father in silence so he can hear from God, so he can receive the power of God, because that's where true power comes from. Yeah, I praise God for this time of the 18 days and fasting and praying and what we're doing. Man, I felt the drink of the Holy Spirit last night like I haven't felt in probably 6 months. But man, you know where true power comes from is when you're alone with God as well. Seek him in the secret. If you seek me in secret, the Lord says, I will reward you openly. And Jesus just wanted a break. He wanted to get away from everything and everybody. He needed a break. He needed to get that fresh drink from his Father. He needed that fresh encouragement. And how much more do we? Jesus Christ is our example. He's our example. So if Jesus Christ, I doubt any of you are more anointed and more godly than the Lord Jesus Christ. And if he needed to be alone with his Father in silence, how much more do we? Are you stronger than Jesus? Because I ain't. Man, I mean, I'm not talking about a 5-minute daily devotional before you go to work. Man, seek him in secret. Get to know God. We need to get alone with God, spend time with God so we can get to know God so the hand of God will be up on our lives for everything. And you know, we whine, oh, I'm so weak, I'm so this, I'm so that. How much time are you spending with God? You know what I'm saying? Like, really, how much time are you spending with God? You know, Jesus, man, he's our example. He's our example, man. He had to get alone with God. He needed to spend time with God. I just wanted to give you guys a little nugget here. I know the Lord is speaking to me. You know when you're in those times of prayer, and some of you know what I'm talking about, when you're spending time with God, right, and you're just, man, you just feel energized, right, by the Spirit of God. You know, when you're in that time of prayer, all of a sudden that spirit of intercession comes upon you. That spirit of prayer comes upon you. Listen, don't leave so quickly, man. If you feel energized in prayer, if there. Nothing else is more important than that. Because that's when you will prevail if you stay there. You're touching God then. Don't just get up so quickly, especially if you feel energized in prayer. I'm telling you, man, there have been times where I'm just getting ready to get up, and then the Spirit of God will just fall and energize me. And sometimes I'll go for an hour and a half, 2 hours, and man, I'm just breaking through that obscurity and just getting that drink, man. But man, don't leave so quickly. Don't leave so quickly. I'm telling you, man, you want the power of God on your life, learn to be sensitive to your spirit. The more you pray and get along with God, the more sensitive you will be to that. You know, I want to encourage you guys with that. But let's move on real quick. Verses 25 through 27. Now in the fourth watch of the night, 3 o'clock in the morning, Jesus went to them walking upon the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, "Man, it's a ghost!" And they cried out with fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Be of good cheer, it is I, don't be afraid." So check it out. This is crazy. So all this is going on simultaneously, right? So we have I got ADD. Forgive me. So if you guys can check your phones, and I'm not trying to embarrass anybody. But here's the picture, right? So they're in the middle of the sea. They're in a boat. They're in the middle of the sea, right? It's windy. The waves are blasting up on the boat. The waves are hitting the boat. It's windy. It's howling. And it's 3 o'clock in the morning, so it's pitch black. And here comes this being just walking on the water right towards them. Dude, I would tweak out. I don't know about you. Think about all that going on simultaneously. And then Jesus Christ, and he's so faithful. He's so faithful to speak, "Be of good cheer. It is I. Don't be afraid." Man, I want to tell you something. This Jesus Christ is not bound to natural law. Listen, if he wants to skip a boat ride and walk on the water and meet up with you, he's got that down. He's got that. But, man, here's the key. Listen, I want you to know something, man. Jesus knew that they were going to face trouble. Jesus knew that they were going to be in danger, right? And he was completely aware of it. But he allowed it so he could test their faith, so he can encourage them in their walk, so he can let them know that who he really is, right? So Jesus knew what was going on. Jesus was testing their faith. He was allowing them to go through the fire. He was allowing them to be in that storm. He was allowing them to suffer. He was allowing them to get attacked with fear and anxiety. He allowed it so they could come out refined like steel, so they could come out strengthened, so they could come out with their faith built, because that's the only thing that really matters is your faith. And if you have faith in God, you can walk through anything. And if right now, if you are suffering, and if you are in the spirit right now, but yet at the same time, if you're suffering, man, dude, you can rest in that, man. I'm telling you. Listen, God will allow you and I. The book of Acts says, we must go through many hardships in order to enter the kingdom of God. Listen, we got to go through many hardships. God didn't call us to an easy life. If you're a Christian here tonight, man, you signed up to die. You signed up to die to this world. You signed up to die to self. And you signed up to live for Jesus Christ radically. Radically. And listen, if you're in a storm tonight, if you are in a time of suffering, listen to me. Pray for wisdom. And all you're getting, get understanding. Because it's not the suffering that's going to make you strong. It's suffering it's having wisdom in the midst of your suffering. How many Christians do you know that have went through a time of testing and then went through a time of suffering, that shipwreck, that fell away? It's wisdom. It's having wisdom in the midst of suffering. And you can rejoice in that, because you can be like, "Oh, praise God, I understand. I know that I'm going to come out refined like steel. Thank you, Jesus, for this time of suffering, because I know that your hand is on it. Lord, you said you're going to work out all things for good for those who love God and call according to your purpose. God, I'm going to rest in this storm. I'm going to rest in this time of suffering, because I know I'm going to come out strong. I know I'm going to come out empowered. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to rest and trust in you through this storm." We need wisdom in suffering, and especially in the coming days. Things are going to get crazy down here, and you're going to need that wisdom. You're going to need that understanding. Hear me. Get wisdom, and all you're getting, get understanding. Know what's going on. Know why you're in this thing. Jesus, why am I going through this? Because he loves you. That's why. He cares about your faith. He cares about your character. He's for battling and, you know, this night of confusion, I want you to know it's ordained by God. It's ordained by God. Don't listen to those false teachers. No, no, no. It's all through the Bible, man. He's called us to suffer for one reason, so we can grow strong in Him, so we can encourage others. He cares more about our heart and our character than anything else. And if we have faith, because going through that season of suffering, going through that season of trial, having wisdom in it, that's where it's at, man. And you're going to come out 5 times stronger. Endure. Endure hardship as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus. He says, immediately He spoke to them, "Be of good cheer. It is I. Don't be afraid." Man, that's the thing, man. Jesus Christ, when He enters your life, when he comes through in that time of suffering, it's instant relief. It's instant breakthrough, man. Jesus Christ will silence it all. Whatever you're going through, instant silence. If it's that financial breakthrough, dude, He's sovereign. Whatever it is, man, whatever you're going through, that answer, He will speak to you. But man, endure hardship as a good soldier. He's going to come through, and He will glorify you. Man, you will receive that crown of glory for those who love Him, as the word says in James. Man, endure it. Endure it. And let's move on for time's sake. So much more there. But remember that wisdom and suffering. It's not only suffering. Many have shipwrecked because of suffering and testing. They just fall away left and right. It's having wisdom and suffering that will make you strong, that will bring you through it, and you'll have understanding, and you can praise God through every second of it. I'm telling you, man. Verses 28 through 29. And Peter answered him and said, "Lord, if it is You, command me to come to You on the water." So He said, here's the word, "Come." And when Peter had come down out of the boat, he walked upon the water. This is awesome. This is awesome. He said, man, Peter came out of the boat. Listen, many people, many pastors hate upon Peter. Oh, that's just Peter being Peter again. Dude, Peter is known for his courage. Yeah, he was hasty, but he was known for his zeal and his courage. He was a wild man for Jesus, and he loved it. Listen, Peter came out of the boat, man. When Jesus came and when He revealed Himself, Peter was willing to fight through whatever he had to fight through water, to fight through fire. He'll fight through anything to get to Jesus Christ. And man, Jesus loved that about him. Man, Peter was zealous. He had a sincere faith and a love for Jesus Christ. He was hasty. He did a lot of crazy things. But man, listen, Peter had a sincere faith in Jesus Christ. Let me tell you something. Man, he was the only one. He was a soldier, man. He is the only one that knows what it's like to walk up on the raging sea. All the others stayed in a boat, man. Jesus said, "Come." That's the key word, man. And Peter, he came down out of the boat. He came down out of the boat and he started walking up on the water. He knows what it's like to walk up on the water. Listen, man, you know, Jesus, man, He commanded them to walk on the water. He's calling us to a sincere, faithful walk in Him, man. He's calling us to have a walk strong in faith, man. He's calling us to a supernatural walk, to walk up on the winds and the waves, to walk up on the storms, to trust in Jesus, to obey Him. And listen, Peter, here is the message right here. Peter left his comfort and security to trust in the Lord completely. He left the boat. He left his comfort. He left his security. He left the boat. He's like, "You guys can stay here, but man, I want more. I want Jesus. I'm going to go to Him. I don't care if I'm in danger. I know that He's faithful to catch me. I know He's got my back. I know He'll fight for me through every step of the way." Man, Jesus is faithful, dude. He's faithful, man. Get out of the boat, man. And doing the same thing, man. The Christians need to get out of the church. We need to get out of the norm. Man, it's not enough just coming to church on Wednesday and Sunday. He's calling us to a supernatural, powerful walk, to walk with Jesus Christ, to walk in His power, to know what it's like, to walk on water, to walk on the winds and the waves of His life, to step on the neck of anxiety, to step on the neck of fear. James, why are you preaching like that? I don't know. Maybe people have been praying lately. Listen, He's calling us to that real walk. He's calling you and I to know Him more than we ever did before. It's more than just coming to church. It's more than just doing this little stuff we've been doing. enough. Stop looking at these other, help me, Lord. Stop looking at these other churches. What's the word of God saying? What's he saying to you? What do you want? Listen, what do you want? Do you want to stay the same? Do you want to stay the same where you are right now? Listen, I don't, man. I want to walk in his fullness. I want to know what it's like to step on the sea, to step on the raging sea, to step on the neck of Satan. I want to know what it's like to completely trust in God, to have that rich faith that he talks about. I want to know what it's like. And I ain't there yet. I'm with you. I'm in the same boat. I want to get out of that boat. I want out of that boat, man. I don't care. I don't care about security anymore. I just do or die. Do or die. You know what I mean? But let me ask you this question. This is coming to my mind right now. Are you satisfied with where you're at, with your walk with Christ? Let me ask you this other question. And think, listen to me. Let me ask you this other question. Where are you at? Where you are right now in your spiritual state and in the character you have right now, are you ready to die and stand before the Lord Jesus Christ? Before glorification, when you die, and before glorification, you will stand before the Lord Jesus Christ with the same spirituality that you have right now, with the same character you have right now, and you'll give an account. Before glorification, you'll be fully known as you're known now. Are you ready? Are you ready right now? I'm not. I'm just being honest with you. I'm not. Man, I fear, man, the judgment seat of Christ. I fear that. You know, I want to be ready. I want to be unashamed. I want to know God. I just want to have boldness. It talks about boldness. You know what I mean? Perfect love casts out all fear. That's the answer. Pursue love, man. Pursue Christ. Pursue him and his fullness. Man, that's what we need, man. That's what we all need. But he's calling us. He's calling us out of the boat, man. He's saying to you, he's saying to me, get out of the shallow end of your comfort. Get out of the shallow end of your security. Put away those stupid, all this stuff, man, that you're reading, and get, what's the word of God said? Put away those stupid commentaries, and get, what's the word of God said? Let's I don't care about these men. The Holy Spirit promises to teach us all truth. What's the word of God said? Stop comparing yourself to other churches. Compare yourself, your life, to the word of God. And what does it say? Man, God is calling us, man. He's saying, get out of the shallow end. The shallow end's dangerous, by the way. Man, I'm calling you. I'm calling all of you to into the deep end. Get out of the shallow end. Take a leap of faith. You want the baptism of the Holy Spirit? Forsake all that stupid pursuit of money and riches and worldliness. You can't have both. You can't have the world and you can't have the power of God. What's it going to be? What do you want? It's do or die, too. It's that dangerous. It's hell dangerous. What's it going to be? Man, God is calling us out, man. He wants us to walk into the deep end. He wants us to jump into the deep end. We have to obey the word of God. It's not enough just confessing. We have to forsake sin. We have to pursue God. We have to pursue him with all of our heart. We got to stop living in this balance. Like, yeah, I can have this and have this and have this and have. No, man. It's one or the other. Do you want the power of God upon your life? Do you want the presence of God upon your life? Do you want to walk on water, or do you want to keep being choked out by worldliness and anxiety? Hey, know that I'm preaching to myself, too. I'm not preaching down to nobody. I know, man, God's been dealing with me, man, and I fear the Lord, man. I love God. I do, and I pursue him, but I fear God. Fear the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Man, but God wants, he will break those chains, man. He will break those chains. Verse 30 and 31. But when he saw that the wind was boisterous, he was afraid and beginning to sink. He cried out, saying, Lord, save me. And immediately, Jesus stretched out his hand and caught him and said, Oh, you of little faith, why do you doubt? God is so faithful, man. And why did Jesus issue the I'm just thinking out loud through prayer. But the first was to show Peter how powerful Christ is. But the second, he allowed Peter to sink a little bit to show him how weak he is so he can depend on Christ. You know what I mean? Like, he knows. He's called us all out. Every single one of you, brothers and sisters, we're all called to radically pursue God. He's called us to, you know, callings that are bigger than ourselves. Some of us are still waiting on that call for missions and church planting, whatever it is. He's called us out, man. And he's called us to do the impossible. He's called us to walk up on the water. And he knows we're going to stumble, man. He wasn't tripping about Peter. He knew Peter was going to stumble, man. The greatest men of God, the greatest men and the greatest women of God. They all, man, listen, Peter had faith to walk on the water. Don't get it twisted. It isn't like, oh, Peter had pretty poor faith. No, no, no. He walked on the water. He really walked on the water. He walked a supernatural walk. He walked up on the water. But even the greatest men and women of God have to wrestle with fear and anxiety, man. That's just a fact. That's just a fact. Every single one of us has to wrestle with that. Every single one of us has to wrestle with depression, especially if you're called to ministry. You know, depression and anxiety and fear. And, man, though you have faith and it's like this war, man. But the only answer is to cry out to Jesus Christ, to cry out to God, to spend more time with God. Listen, man, where are you at? Are you struggling right now with fear and with anxiety? Are you struggling with the pull of the world and worldliness? Are you struggling with just doubting God? Are you struggling in your prayer life? Then those spiritual alarms in your head just start ringing and ringing. Fast and pray. Fast and pray. Man, Peter cried out to God and Jesus instantly lifted him up, man. It wasn't that he waited so long. Man, he came through immediately. He does that for every single one of us. Prayer, crying out to Jesus Christ is your only answer. Man, no prescription pill, no Xanax, no reefer, no entertainment, no nothing will deliver you from that. It's the power of the Holy Spirit. It's crying out to Jesus Christ. And he promises instant relief from anxiety, instant relief from fear. Man, God is so faithful, man. That's it. He cried out to the Lord and he lifted him up. But every single one of us has to wrestle with that. But the only way to conquer that is spending more time with God, more time in prayer, more time in fellowship, but obeying God. Obeying God, not forsaking the assembling of yourselves together. Guys, I encourage you to come out, man. To come out, man. It's a time of prayer and fasting, 6 o'clock to 10 o'clock every single night, man. It's prayer and fasting, man. It's between you and the Lord with the fast. But I'm telling you, man, every single one of us has a spiritual fuel line that's connected to God. And it gets clogged up with our stupid worldliness and pursuing of the world and all these different stuff and sin. And it gets clogged up where, man, your connection isn't really so clear. But I'm telling you, when you fast and when you pray and when you come together, I'm telling you, man, instant relief, instant relief, instant relief. Every time he will cleanse you. You can have that clarity and that power and that faith and that quickening, man. I'm telling you, Peter jumped out of the boat, man. He was ready to throw himself into the mouth of hell, dude. Man, I praise God for that. Man, I encourage you guys to come out and seek the face of the living God. I'm telling you, last night I've had a drink from the Holy Spirit like I haven't had in 6 months. It's like Jesus just gave me a drink, gave me a glass full of the Holy Spirit. So I'm going to look at it. You know, it was awesome, dude. Nothing's better than that, man. Nothing's better. Nothing else can satisfy. Stop believing the lies. If I start buying this or pursuing this or, you know, or chasing worldliness. No, 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 no. You're believing a lie. You're giving into the same lie. No. Only Christ can satisfy. I'm telling you. Listen, man. Okay, but listen. The message. Oh, sorry, guys. I got a couple more minutes here. So much, man. But, you know, the gist of that message, you know, it talks about the sea, right? It talks about the sea. And the word of God, the word sea is usually mentioned. It has to do with humanity. The sea of humanity that no man can count. Just as the Lord Jesus Christ has called Peter out of the boat to walk upon the water, the Holy Spirit in these last days is calling out to the church. The Holy Spirit's calling out to his children. Come, come and walk upon the sea. Walk with me. Join me on this rescue mission of lost humanity. It's the same thing, man. The Holy Spirit's calling out his church to leave your security. And stop, who cares about your insurance and all that? Dude, leave your security. Leave your comfort and follow me in saving lost humanity. And don't worry about the wind and the waves of anxiety. I got your back. Don't worry about the fear of man. You follow me. You keep your eyes on me. You will step on the neck of fear. You'll step on the neck of the fear of man. You'll step on the neck of anxiety. Man, you'll step on the neck of doubt. Doubt is that root, man, that rises. That's the kingpin sin, man, is doubt. And everything springs up from there. But, man, fasting and praying issues the power of God to release doubt out of your heart so faith will arise. Man, it's only your faith that moves the power of God upon your life. It's your faith in God that's going to pull that spirit of anxiety off of you and cast it and chokeslam it into hell. Man, I'm telling you, the Spirit of God is calling us out. He's calling us out. Just focus on me. Come, the Holy Spirit's in. Come and join me in rescuing the lost humanity. Don't worry about your security. Be like Peter. Oh, when you fall, I got your back. I got you. As long as you obey me, I'll catch you every time. Every time you fall, I got your back, man. I'm sovereign. I'm omnipotent. I'm omnipresent. I got you. You just follow me. Obey me. Seek my face. Man, but in these last days, we're in those last days, man. And it's time to get that oil. The Lord has been dealing with me about that oil. The Holy Spirit, man. We got to get that oil now. Listen, the darkest of days are just before us. Things are about to get crazy, crazy, crazy down here. It doesn't matter what your view of the rapture is. I don't even care what your view of the rapture is. The Bible promises we're going to see suffering. We're going to see suffering, man. And I encourage you guys, listen, to get that oil now. You start pursuing the Lord Jesus Christ right now. I'm telling you, start push away that worldliness. Put God first. Get your house in order. Man, I'm talking about me. I'm talking about all of us. To get our house in order. To get that Holy Spirit oil. The days that are just ahead of us. Daniel, one of the greatest men of God in the Bible. Daniel, the Lord showed him the days that we're living in, the last days. And this man fell on his face like dead, and he trembled. And that's Daniel. He trembled? How much more should we? We got to take this serious, man. It's time to get that oil now. I pray. Get that Holy Spirit oil now. You radically pursue the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm telling you, right now is the time. God has given the United States of America a window of grace, a window of opportunity to get your house in order, dude. To get your heart right, to get your house in order. He's given us a window of opportunity to get that oil. He's given America, churches in the United States, a window of opportunity to get that oil. To get that oil now, because let me tell you something. Most churches in the United States do not have that oil, and they will go to hell. You read the Word of God and look at the churches, man. I can start sharing a bunch of stories right now, and I can't. But man, I'm telling you, it's time to get that oil now. Listen, man, the deepest, deep darkness is about to fall. We need to get that oil now, so our lamps will be burning, so we're not overtaken by darkness. It's time right now to radically pursue the Lord Jesus Christ like we never had before. Man, I do not want, listen, the Bible promises many are going to fall away. Many, there's going to be a great falling away from the Lord Jesus Christ. There's going to be a great falling away. I don't want that to happen to you. They fall away because they don't have the oil. They're not ready to face what's coming. Their hearts fail because of fear. I don't want that to happen to you. I'm talking to you. I'm not even talking about them. I'm talking to you. I don't, man, there may be some here, I don't know your heart, but I don't want this cry to come out from your lips. Oh, my lamp has gone out. The harvest is past and the summer has ended. And we are not saved. Heed the voice of God. Man, it's time to put everything away and radically pursue the Lord Jesus Christ, because darkness is going to fall so hard and so fast where you won't have the time to get the oil. When that happens, you won't be able to run up to those who are running strong with the Lord. You know, you can't run up to that person like, oh, my heart, it's failing me. Help me, help me, help me. There'll be nothing we can do for you in that day. There'll be nothing that even Pastor Scott can do for you in that day. You have to get the oil now. We have to seek the Lord Jesus Christ now. We have to get ready now. Now, not later, now. You know, and man, it isn't like, you know, when you come to us, if that's you, I pray that it's not. But I pray that it won't be like, you know, it's not like I can get a glass and all of a sudden go and fill it with the Holy Spirit and you drink it. No, it's my own personal oil. I can't give it to you. Yeah, but you got to get that oil yourself. You got to seek God yourself. I'm not talking about 10-minute daily devotion in the morning. I'm talking about really pursuing God, getting that oil and getting ready now. Now. But man, the Lord is faithful. God, he's so faithful. You know, just as Jesus Christ wrote, rose from the dead. That same power will live in you. You get that oil, you'll walk through the darkest of times. You'll step on the neck of all fear, all anxiety. You will be fine. But make sure you get the oil now. Get that oil right now. I'm talking radically pursue God, because things are going to hit the fan really fast. And it's time to get that oil now. But God is so faithful. He's got your back. If you set your face to pursue the Lord Jesus Christ, He will meet you. He will pour out His Spirit upon you. He will fill you. Your lamps will shine. And just as Jesus Christ rose from the dead, man, that same power lives in you. Remember, the grave is undefeated. The grave has never lost a match until that glorious day that Christ sacrificed Himself and they laid Him in a tomb, and an omnipotent power hit the Lord Jesus Christ, and Jesus rocked the grave. He rose from the dead, and you will rock the grave too. You will rock these days that lie ahead. He will prepare you. He'll do the work. But you got to obey Him. Obey Him now. Obey Him now. I pray that God has spoken to you, guys. He loves you so much. He promises, man. What breakthrough do you need in your life? Are you struggling with worldliness and the pursuit of whatever? What are you struggling with, man? I encourage you, get right with God. It's time to repent. It's not time yet. Praise God if there's conviction. But conviction is not enough, man. Go home and fight with that thing until it's gone. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, man, to seek the Lord now while He may be found, man. We have a window of opportunity. Man, there's going to be a great falling away. Broad is the way that leads to hell. Many go that route. He's talking about the churches, man. He's not even talking about unbelievers in that time. How do I know? Because the next verse says, many will come to me on that day and say, Lord, Lord. And they say, depart from me. I never knew you. I never knew you. You came to church, but we didn't know each other. We didn't commune with one another. Come on, man. It's time to get to know God. It's time to spend time with God so we get to know God. So we can get to know God. He loves you so much, man. He loves you more than you love yourself. He will baptize your heart. He will pour out His Spirit upon you, man. He will make you strong. He will make you ready. But, man, we got to heed the call. We got to seek the Lord now. Amen?
Amen?
Man, Father, I pray right now in the name of Jesus Christ, God. Lord, I pray, God, whatever you just spoke, just use it, God. Just use it, Lord. I don't even know, God. You just totally curve this message, God. I just thank you so much for speaking. I thank you that you are faithful, Lord. I pray, God, that you would help us to get our oil, God. I pray that you would make us ready, God. I pray that you would give us grace to seek your face, God. I pray that you would give us a healthy fear of you, but God, give us that understanding of your love for us, God. Never will you leave us. Never will you forsake us, God. Give us wisdom, God, when we have to go through suffering, God. We need you right now, God. I pray that you would come and energize us to pray, God. I pray for boldness, God. I pray for fire in bellies, God, to just lift their voices and pray now, God. Please, God, in Jesus Christ's name, we commit this time to you, Lord. I pray you come against that dullness, Lord. We need you, God. In Jesus' name. Feel free to pray, my brothers and sisters.
resist your intervention, Lord, then invade. Compel them.